It even said, it even apologized.
I know.
I feel bad.
I'm not going to say thank you. Snoop Dogg!
What's going on, everybody? My name is Mike Roddy. Welcome back to my channel. And today I have my reoccurring guest, Alfredo Urbano.
What up?
What is good? What is good?
You know, man, just sitting here Thursday, March 16th, 4 p.m., about to drop some bombs.
Let's fucking go. If you guys have watched in the previous video, we did go over some foundational pillars for ChatGPT with the help of Alfredo. Today, we're going to go just a little bit more specific. We're going to actually be talking about how to help you guys create more content ideas because, you know, when we onboard clients or even me on a sales call with a lead, almost every single person has the same reoccurring issue, and it's that they just don't know what to shoot. They don't know what content is going to work for their page. So rather than just testing content natively, they're overthinking it. So this is a really good way for anybody who overthinks content. This has happened to everybody, including myself, to just help kind of eliminate that entire issue. So let's dive in.
All right. So this video is going to be focused on content ideas. Now, do we have our persona, our character?
Yes.
Our client.
Our first individual.
Name drop them.
Should we actually give him like a name?
No.
Okay, I was gonna say, yeah.
We'll call him Josh Uwa.
Josh Uwa?
Yeah, it's Hebrew.
Oh. All right, so we're gonna start with the business niche. I help people leave the 9-to-5, their 9-to-5 job, and help them build an agency and get them their first client within 30 days. Actually, that's weak. Let's give them like their first 5 clients within 60 days.
Okay. So we're talking agency owner, helping other people start agencies.
We're talking about a beginner.
Is it
that person who...
Any type of agency?
Any type of agency.
Okay.
So let's call it content marketing.
Okay. All right. So here's what we got.
What do we got?
And I don't know
explain to them the process here and why you are saying the things you're saying.
Okay, so...
Also, is this ChatGPT... Is this the new version?
No, this is the free version.
Oh, it's the free version.
Yeah, I don't
okay,
no
cool.
Excuses.
I was just gonna, yeah, I was just gonna say we should also preface it just in case.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, we have the plus version, but all that does is make it faster.
Okay.
So, here we go. I am an agency owner, and I help individuals start their own agency. So you're telling ChatGPT about who you are and what you do, your business, right? Got to give ChatGPT some context. If you said I'm an agency owner and give me content ideas, ChatGPT is gonna give you like very generic stuff. I am beginning to create content to promote my services and business. Here is some more information about my offer. So that's context. On top of context.
Like it?
Even more context.
All right.
I helped them get 5 clients within 60 days, starting their own content marketing agency.
Right.
So 3 lines of context so far.
Okay. So arguably context is the most imperative part of this process.
I don't even want to say most imperative. What I would say is you can always provide more information.
Okay.
Obviously, you want to have, if I were to just hit enter, ChatGPT would be like, that's cool, man. I'm really happy for you, and it sounds like you're doing great. So you have to have context, but on top of that,
right.
Hit them with the goal.
Hit them with the goal.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. So this is the goal, right? Help me come up with 10 content ideas. 8 video-based ideas, 2 picture-based ideas. Label them accordingly. Now, this is live. A little bit complex in terms of instruction, so we'll see what ChatGPT gives us back. But we're gonna hit send on this one.
God. Please give us something good. Here we go. All right. So number one, success stories. Share real life success stories of individuals who have started their own content marketing agency with your help. Label success stories. Okay. FAQ. FAQs. Okay, cool. Create a video answering frequently asked questions about starting a content marketing agency. Tips and tricks. Share your tips and tricks for building a successful content marketing agency.
Client testimonials. Share video testimonials from satisfied clients. Case studies of individuals who have started and built their own agency using your services. Q&A sessions, how-to videos, sharing content marketing agency, how to create a website or find clients, and industry trends that you notice inside of your industry. And then for the pictures, we've got infographics, so some value add there. And then before and after photos, so individuals who have used your services, and then after. Now, that's pretty good.
The only one I don't like is infographics because I just don't like infographics, but I'm a little biased. But everything else, if you were to just ask them for generic content ideas that for beginners who are just learning how to build an agency, that is pretty damn good.
Not bad.
The only issue is that if you're just starting out with an agency, you probably don't have case studies, testimonials.
Okay, yeah. You're saying if you were the business owner and you just started this service.
Oh, you know what? I'm fucking up. That's me. No, we are talking as the person that is running the offer.
Right.
So, yes, they do have
this. So, let's say you get this far.
Okay.
And this is you and you want to do this and... You're like, oh, these are great ideas. Let me do some FAQs. And you're like, wait a minute. I don't know what to even talk about. Let's take one of these ideas and expand upon it and have ChatGPT give us some questions that we might be able to provide to our audience.
I like that. Let's go off that one.
All right, here we go. So what I'm telling ChatGPT is, I like idea number two. Let's throw some FAQs on my account, but I don't know what to talk about. I'm a little shy. So I said, I like idea number two. Let's expand upon it. So now we're already telling ChatGPT where to put its focus.
Okay.
Give me five FAQs someone interested in starting a content marketing agency would be interested in learning about. That's the goal. This is the context. Give them in question response format. That's the specificity. So now we're giving more information, ChatGPT, on how it should frame its responses to us.
Got it. Okay.
Make them informing, engaging, and provide an actual step for each one. That's more specificity.
Boom. Sending it.
All right. Let's go through the first two. How can I choose a profitable niche for my content marketing agency?
Ooh. Oh, you can also check out my niche video on YouTube. But anyways, keep going.
All right. So here's what... Let's see what ChatGPT has given us in terms of information and see if it's worth anything.
Let's do it. Yeah.
To choose a profitable niche, you need to consider your target audience, industry trends, and competition. Start by identifying a specific problem or pain point that your audience is experiencing, then focus on offering unique solutions that set you apart from the competition. Once you've identified that niche, create a content marketing strategy that aligns with your target's audience needs and interests. So that's what you would be saying in terms of the video, or at least that's your jumping off point for what you want to talk about.
Gotcha.
For this FAQ. So now you've got five video ideas and you can start an FAQ series where you post once a week an FAQ. Yeah. And now you've got a series on your content.
Variety, guys. Remember that content is also about variety. Nobody wants to see the same shit over and over again. So this is going to really help build a bigger arsenal of variety of content for you, because the more variety you have, the more engaging and entertaining your personal brand is. But all of these are really good. I mean,
yeah. How can I create high quality content for clients? How can I scale my content marketing agency? How can I find clients? Pretty good. Obviously very FAQ. Like, that's a very frequently asked question.
Yeah. I mean, they really aren't that broad either, because we're specifically talking about content marketing agencies. So I think this is like...
And that's the importance of the context and the specificity.
Right. Because if you just said agency, right, then it's going to go way too broad.
Right.
So yeah, like more specific on the actual sub-niche of the agency.
Now let's flip it and do another industry and see if we can come up with some stuff.
Okay, let's do it.
All right, what do we got?
Life coaches. Yeah.
I need more.
Okay. So I am a life coach that helps somebody overcome past traumas to strengthen them as a individual in life and improve their relationship with their loved ones. Would their past traumas, or would it be plural trauma? Is it one of those words where it's like trauma or trauma? Does it matter? Is it so smart that it won't even matter?
Geese or geeses?
Goose and geese. You fucking idiot.
I don't think it matters. Here we have it. Presenting industry number two. I am a life coach that helps people overcome past traumas, strengthen them as an individual in life, and improve their relationship with their loved ones.
Love it.
That's the context. Now ChatGPT knows who we are. I am starting an Instagram and TikTok account so I can promote my services as a life coach and help them. And I need help coming up with content ideas. Even more context. Give me six content ideas for videos I can use. Goal.
Make them engaging and up to date with trends relevant today. And also
specificity.
How about this? Make them engaging, up to date with trends relevant today, and add an emotional tone, an uplifting emotional tone.
Here we go. We used a vocab word in that one.
Boom.
Let's see.
Oh, those are all, these are all literally all captions that I have written in the past for
5 daily habits to overcome trauma and build stronger relationships with yourself. Hashtag trauma.
Fire.
Okay, that's fucked up.
Hashtag trauma. Yeah, well, I mean, like, yeah, I wouldn't hashtag trauma, but, or maybe I would. I don't know. I mean, yeah, it's probably a dark hashtag. I wouldn't want to use that. Either way, I mean, like, that's still a really freaking good idea.
Yeah,
because
so it's saying create a short video highlighting simple daily habits that can help people overcome their past traumas. Show them how these habits can lead to a strong relationship. What if you're like, dude, I don't know what to talk about on that one? Gratitude practice, exercise, journaling, and connecting with others.
Powerful. And real. Also really good. Yeah. I mean, good. Like, we've worked with life coaches. Those are all like things that are like productized. Like, those are like the generic words, but like people productize it. You know, it's like faith, family, finance, and I don't know.
This one's interesting. Let's talk about trauma in a healthy way, of course. Understanding and coping with childhood trauma. Share your insights and experiences on how people can cope with childhood trauma and how it affects their present lives. Gratitude for healing. Three simple practices to cultivate gratitude and happiness. You could get ChatGPT to expand if you don't come up with those on your own. Use ChatGPT as a jumping off point. And then add your own tone, voice, expertise, and personality so that we're not running an AI account.
I also really like the last one, the power of forgiveness. How letting go can help you heal and move forward. Something Alfredo should learn when it comes to people leaving their garbage in the office.
Maybe if you made it into a reel, I could watch it and save it and learn.
Well, let's fucking do it then. Put it in ChatGPT.
All right. Let's say, I don't know how to shoot video day number 6. What should I do, robot? It's so disrespectful. ChatGPT, you're not a robot. You're so much more than that.
Yeah, say nice things to it. Because like when they go live and they kill everybody, like I want them to be like, you were nice to me.
I remember.
I remember.
All right, plan the content, choosing the location, set up the equipment, prepare yourself, review the footage, edit the video. Okay, very generic. That's not what I meant.
Be nice to him, her. Ugh, it even apologized.
I know.
I feel bad.
I'm not gonna say thank you. Snoop Dogg. Okay, so as you can see, I'm using a very conversational way of speaking to the robot, right? Like, there's no, like, bracket, please, end bracket, underscore, enter information. Like, just talk to it. Like,
yeah.
Get what you want out of it. You know what I mean? So here's what it gave us. Introduction, introduce the concept of forgiveness, define forgiveness, the benefits of it, steps to it, examples of it, and then the conclusion.
That is so good. Those are, it's literally fire. Yeah, that's right. Give it a little thank you. A little affirmation. You know what I mean?
This improves responses, guys. Just kidding. I have no data to back that up.
I wonder if like ChatGPT eventually will just start scoring users on like how much of
a like piece an Uber, to, Uber driver.
Yeah, exactly. It's like thank you. It's like, wow, for once. What did you say? You laughed, I laughed, ChatGPT laughed. Ha ha, ha ha ha.
So there we go. I mean, we've got ideas and it told you how to do it if you've never operated a cellular device, and then also how to talk about the specific content idea. And you could keep going. Like, you could be like, give me more info on step number 1. How do I introduce myself? This is who I am. What are the steps to forgiveness?
Yeah, this is fucking killer. Well, guys, so we wanted to give you guys a little bit of a variety of different niches, help you guys understand how to create some really good content ideas for your personal brand, depending on what industry or niche you're in. We've successfully been able to do that within, I don't know, probably under 15 minutes with 2 different niches. So the possibilities for you guys are endless. This is literally the easiest strategy for you guys to alleviate the overcomplication of thinking through ideas. You know, we understand that it's definitely hard. There's times where you get a creative block, but this pretty much eliminates that. So appreciate you guys for watching. Alfredo, thank you for being on.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for saying thank you.
Thank you, ChatGPT. For having us.
All right, guys. Appreciate you guys for watching. Share us with a friend. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell for notifications. We'll see you in the next video. Peace.
Did not record.